taking off the gloves. I've had enough. It's in my blood. I was born for this.
What is NBA Top Shot? How do you get into it? What is the moment you want to know? I've got the information. I'm completely immersed on the platform into the hobby right now. I'm going to give you guys my information, a beginner's guide, and also some advanced stuff on serial numbers, putting stuff into the marketplace, community, a little bit about my collection here. I'm going to dive into that here for you guys in this video, all-encompassing beginner's guide with a little bit of advanced stuff here as well. Anyone telling you they're an expert in this is lying. I'm going to give you guys my information based on my experience and what I've done. The things I don't know, I'm not going to dive into, but everything that I have here is going to get you up and running and aware of what NBA Top Shot is, and it's going to give you a good idea on whether or not you want to get into it, because I've got a lot of experience in fantasy football and sports cards, and this is new to a lot of people, right? I've also dabbled a little bit in cryptocurrency. I'm not going to say that I'm a crypto maniac or anything like that, but I've got a good understanding of crypto and blockchain and that type of thing as well. So I'm going to give you guys my information. Before I do, guys, make sure you guys subscribe, turn on the bell. More NBA Top Shot videos coming your way. Leave your comments below, questions. Love to get your feedback on this. I'm going to give you guys my information based on what I know. So first of all, what is NBA Top Shot? What is it, guys? It's a digital collectible platform based on blockchain. So let me repeat that. A digital collectible platform. So you buy sports cards, it's a physical card. This is a video. You're basically buying a video of an assist, a pass, a dunk, a three-point shot, two-point shot, a layup. You're getting all of these variations of NBA athletes. Now, I don't know if every NBA athlete's in here, but pretty much everyone that I like is seen. I've got, in my collection, I've got Ayton, I've got Bam, I've got Zion. So you go in, look up Zion, and you're gonna see videos of these guys, okay? And you can purchase these videos, and you basically own them as part of your collection on the site. Now, this is licensed by the NBA and the NBA Players Association. The NBA is completely involved. They take these clips, they chop them up, NBA Top Shot puts them on their site. They put them in, so there's a couple ways to buy them. You buy them in packs, you buy them with challenges. I'm not gonna dive into challenges because I don't know too much about it. I haven't done challenges, but challenges, to my understanding, you buy X amount of these moments, which are these videos, and you basically earn points. You get, there's a point system, okay? And basically you earn points and you buy more moments, these videos, right? So basically you buy them in packs, or you can buy them from the marketplace, which is where people open up virtual packs. So what is a pack? You basically, a pack is these moments. A moment is these videos. Stick with me, guys. A moment is basically a 5 to 10 second clip video of a player doing an action, a dunk, a layup. That's what a moment is. They call them moments, right? So you purchase a moment and you put it on the marketplace and you list it and you resell it. Now, if you open a pack, that's where you're gonna get some value. But the problem is these packs are very hard to find. In order to get those, you follow NBA Top Shot, their social media. They let you know when the drop is happening, and you go onto the site and you basically try to get one. You refresh your screen, you purchase these packs, and they range from $9, $99. I see them for $1,000. They range, okay? So again, what is NBA Top Shot? It is a website, right? It's a digital collectible platform where they house these moments, these digital clips, and you can buy, sell, or hold these platforms. Relatively new. It's based on blockchain. Now, when you look at these, so you go onto the site and you go into, let's say, you go to packs that are typically always sold out. You go under marketplace and you look up a player. Let's just say I'm looking up Kyle Lowry, okay, from the Raptors. I go and look him up. It's basically, what it's going to open up is the different availability of Kyle Lowry. How can I buy him in the marketplace? And there's going to be different sets. So I'm looking right now, there's a metallic gold set, LE. Now you're going to see LE and CC when you go to the site, when you're looking up these players. LE is limited edition. CC stands for, they're basically going to make more of them. Okay. They're going to make more of this. So CC means they're going to make more available. So if you want to try to aim for the limited edition, because they're not going to make any more of that video available for people to buy. So what the point of this is, guys, it's completely brand new, is that you are basically owning a piece of history. That's the whole focus here digitally. And it's like NBA still kind of owns the clip, to my understanding, but you basically own it. You're a shareholder of it on the site. You can share it on your social media. It's not like something you can use to promote yourself or anything like that, but you are one of X amount of people, depending on what video you get. Like, for example, I'm looking at this three-pointer by Kyle Lowry, Metallic Gold LE Series 1, and it's at a $299. So, again, you are, if you purchase it, the lowest ask right now is $2,299, okay? That's the lowest ask. And what that means, guys, so basically when you click on that, it's whatever it's out of, there's a lowest ask and there's a highest price. And a lot of this is predicated on what people listed at. Now, here's one disadvantage, one thing I dislike with the serial number system. So let's just say it's serial numbered out of 15,000, okay? Now, if it's out of 15,000, you can buy 14,994 and price it the way you want. But somehow the industry or, you know, people are coming together and saying, oh, well, certain serial numbers are worth more than others. Now, stick with me, guys. You go to look up the marketplace, you look up a player, you look at the moment you want, and you see it's out of, let's say, 15,000. You click on it, and then you go to buy one. And then out of, let's say, 15,000, let's say 800 people are selling at the time, and they're going to list it. Serial number 500, serial number 3, serial number, maybe it's the player's jersey number. Everyone's going to have a price, and that's predicated on what people put it at, right? Like, you can basically set the price at this. It's kind of the Wild West, guys. And this is one of the, we're gonna talk about disadvantages right now and things I don't like. This is one of them I don't like. For some reason, people are somewhat valuing some of the earlier numbers. So if it's out of 15,000, people are like, oh, well, you know, number one is worth more than 14,000. Like, but here's how I look at it, guys. And I want you guys, if you're listening to this, if you're new to this, to set the standard with this. You shouldn't base it on, because you're in the same pool. Let me give you an example. If I got a basket, and we put 100 balls in there, purple, let's say they're purple balls. They're all the same ball, all made out of plastic, and they're in this basket. Who am I to say that my purple ball is worth more than your purple ball? Because you're all getting, if you're in that series, you're buying it out of 15,000, you're all getting that same video. Nothing changes. Other than a serial number on it, a serial number should not dictate the price of that video, that moment. Do you understand what I'm saying? So this is very important. I want to implore you guys, don't worry about serial number. Serial number doesn't mean anything. Now I can kind of see it. Maybe if it's a jersey number, that's kind of cool. If the jersey's number 6 and you get the moment that is serial number 6, I mean, that's kind of cool. I definitely see a little bit of inflation there, but people are making up stupid stuff. They're saying, oh, well, if it's number 69, that's cool, or maybe it's his birthday, that's cool. None of this stuff is true. All of this is subjective. All of this is based on what people are saying. I don't really believe in it. I'm just gonna buy a $14,999 because to me, it's the same video, nothing changes. So that's something you need to be aware of if you're getting into it. So let's go back here, back to NBA Top Shot. It's a site, how to buy it. You basically buy it through the marketplace where there's people reselling. You buy it through challenges or you buy it through packs, which are almost impossible to get and you gotta wait for them to drop. You open the pack, you get all these videos. They're random. It's like opening up a box of cards or a pack of cards, okay? So the disadvantage again is like, it's the Wild West right now. So people are just kind of setting the price, right? Like, you know, again, why isn't a $14,999, you know, necessarily worth less than a $499? It's the same video, people. So again, I'm not gonna buy it. So what I do is I look for the lowest ask. I don't care if it's serial numbered 565, or 5,665, I really don't care because I'm getting the same damn video as the guy that got the number 6 video or the number 7 video or the jersey video. It's the same damn video. And again, the variation, the fluctuation of this is insane. So I'm seeing one that's 66 for the lowest ask and one for 222,222. Like, are you kidding me right now? Who's gonna pay $222,000 for a 4-second clip when I can get one for $66? That's the exact same video. You guys see what I'm saying? So stick with me here, guys. I'm just trying to be really passionate, trying to get my point across. Don't worry about serial numbers. Don't believe what Johnny tells you down the door. This is the Wild West. People are just making shit up as they go. They're building the plane as they go down. It doesn't make sense, okay? So let's talk about it. Is this the real deal? Yes, I'd say it's the real deal. You know, people ask if Bitcoin is the real deal. One Bitcoin is like 40, 50, 60 grand, right? Depends. It goes up and down. There's a volatility. With this one, I think it just has to figure out its way. Now, the site is still in beta at the time of this recording. Everything is trying to work its way out right now. I guess people are still trying to figure it out. But again, it's really predicated on how we react to it. So if you react and say the top 10 serial numbers are worth more, then they're probably going to be worth more. But that's BS. Don't do that, guys. just if you really like a player, get the lowest ask. I mean, you're in the market, play, right? So again, this is not, this is my opinion. This is not investing advice. This is my opinion. I'm not telling you, encourage you to do anything, but I'm telling you based on my experience, what's happening. So again, if I look, I like to look, so how do you, who do you get? I like to get players that I like. So for example, I like Shea, so I'm gonna look for Shea videos. Now, a lot of his stuff is really expensive, and people say, is it too early to get in? It's still early, guys. Some people, a lot of people still haven't heard of it. That's why you're watching this video. It, definitely get in if you guys wanna invest in something. So I look up Shea, I look up all his videos, and the one out of 15,000 is the most affordable. The other one's like 2,000, 3,000, because they're out of 299 or whatever. To me, it's like, work within your budget. Get players you like and work within your budget. Don't go crazy on this, because it can get very addictive. And we still don't know. So there's a lot of uncertainty around it. With sports cards, we've got more years to go back and look and say, you know, there's X amount of years. We know the pattern of how things are done and this type of thing. With this one, there's so much uncertainty. And the disadvantage as well is like, what if they say, well, I know the LEs are LE, but what if they bring out 1,000 LEs of that player, 10,000 videos? Now there's so much supply, the demand is gonna drop. So you really need to be sure what's going on. At the time of this video, again, we're recording it, this is a really hot market. People are going crazy for this stuff. When there's a pack drop, people are running to the site. They're selling out within minutes. It's absolutely insane. So again, it's up to you whether you want to invest or not. A lot of this also you need to know is under NFT token. Look up NFT token. I'm not a crypto master. NFT token, what that means is that this, when they create these, they cannot be copied or, and they're all verified. So you got to take a look at that and say, okay, well, it's an LE, it's legit, limited edition. There's so many of that player, you know, of that video, and then you got to make a decision whether you want to invest or not. But again, you know, NBA Top Shot could say, hey, well, we're just going to make another slash 15,000 of a layup and a slash 25,000 out of this. And then it could get oversaturated in videos and these moments, right, which are video clips, 5 to 10 seconds. So again, so what is it again? And should you invest? Is it the real deal? Do I like it? Am I investing? Let's answer those questions. NBA Top Shot is a digital collectible platform which has moments, which are these videos, layups, assists, dunks of players that you love in the NBA. It is licensed by the NBA and the NBA Players Association. It is based on a blockchain platform. You sign up to the site, you put your credit card in when you make a purchase. You go to the marketplace, you look up your player, you look at what's available, what packs are available out of whatever serial number. You look at it, I like the lowest asking price because again, you're in that same basket of purple balls, right? Same basket. Same basket, same video, nothing changed. The video doesn't look altered for the guy that owns serial number 400 compared to the guy that owns serial number 14,993. There's no difference. It's the same video. I don't care which serial number I get, okay? So you go, you make a purchase, and then it becomes part of your collection, and then you can relist it. You can buy, hold, or sell it at your leisure. But again, we cannot let the market decide that, hey, we're just gonna make serial numbers, let's say, for example, 1 to 10 worth more than 4,599. It's the same video. And that's the message I wanna convey with this, guys. Don't go too crazy because again, prices are ridiculous. A lot of these guys open these guys, these videos and packs where they paid $9 and they're selling them for $250,000. So you really have to watch what you're getting. Don't go too crazy. Know your budget because again, this can get out of hand pretty quickly when it talking about your pocketbook, okay? So again, that's what it is. I don't know if I'm missing anything else in here. Oh yeah, these videos and moments come with stats and scores of that particular game. And again, that's pretty much it, guys. It's up to you whether you want to invest in it. It is new. It's exciting, it's hot, it's trending, people are all over this, but still, a lot of people still don't know about it. It's still very, very early to get in, very early. We're on the ground floor with this thing, so if you wanna get in, it doesn't hurt. It really doesn't hurt if you guys got some spare change hanging around, some spare money. Get in, try to get in some packs, find out when the pack breaks are on the social media platforms, and hey, enjoy the hobby, okay? And again, in regards to my collection right now, I've got a Zion Dunk. It's like a 14,000 serial number. Again, I don't care about serial number, but you know, it's a dunk. I got a Bam out of Bio, and I've got a DeAndre Ayton, all base cards. I got a dunk, and I like to go for dunks. Again, I like to go for offense. I don't like assists. That doesn't appeal to me. I like dunks, and I like shots. I don't like assists. I layups. I think they're kind of weak. I like power moves. I like kind of, and I also look for games where, you know, the player has won. You know, if you're looking at NBA Top Shot strategies and investing strategies for NBA Top Shot, again, this may or may not play a factor later, but when I look at a moment in a video I want to buy, right, I look at, first of all, I look at the lowest asking because I'm not going to pay the top price for it, but look at if they actually won that game because I really don't want a moment where, you know, they lost that game. Maybe that could play a factor later, right? So that's very important. I look at the date. I look at like certain things, but ultimately the main thing is I look at the player and the price. That's two criteria I look at. Again, it's up to you on how you want to play. It's the Wild West. It's not like you can go buy a player. It's a PSA 10. You know, the corners are mint. It's a sports card. You are buying a video, basically. And you don't really own it. You own it as part of the marketplace and you're a shareholder of it. That's how I kind of look at it. But again, I would dive in, do a little bit more research yourself. Go onto the NBA site, go onto the site as well, the NBA Top Shot site, and do some investigation. Look into it. Look into NFT token. What is it? Dive into it. Understand it. Understand the process. And look, other sports are coming on to this. This is really hot right now. Everything's digital, right? Everybody wants to own these, you know, moments of history of these players. It's super cool. So again, guys, that's it, guys. That is NBA Top Shot for beginners. Give you a good idea based on my experience. Leave your questions below. Don't worry about serial numbers. Don't let that dictate. Don't let people gouge you. It's the same video. And again, invest wisely, invest smart. Try to get in those packs. It's a very affordable way to get in. But again, it's very hard to get in. You got to be sharp. You got to be on top of the drops and learn about challenges. Dive in, understand what the challenges are. And maybe you could do that. Again, I've done zero challenges right now, but to my understanding, you gotta own a certain amount of cards, and I mean, not keep saying cards, but moments and stuff like that, but I'm not really into that. And again, anyone telling you they're an expert at this is lying because this is brand spanking new. Brand spanking new. I mean, they might have experience like me, but that's it, okay? So follow, subscribe, turn on the bell. More videos coming out as I completely dive into this hobby myself. I'll give you guys some highs and lows from my end, and you guys can dive in, share your stories below as well. Thank you for being here. Subscribe. I'm out. Thank you.